Hey guys, you might remember from 2 weeks ago in my video, I just picked up this 1967 Mustang Fastback and I'm really excited about it. I've had 2 weeks to get a close look at the car and I've developed a strong understanding of the level of project that this car really is going to need. So with that in mind, I started to sketch out an outline of what components the car is going to need and how I want to build it. In this video, I'm going to share with you my build plan. Let's dive in. My favorite style of classic car is a Restomod. Last week, Nick did a really good job of putting together a video that outlined exactly what a Restomod is. So if you haven't seen that, check that out. What I want to build is essentially a Mustang that looks very much original with the exception of the wheels and tires and the stance. I want it to be somewhat understated. Wild Shelby clones and the infamous Eleanor style builds, those are cool, I like them, but that's not exactly what I'm trying to build. I want something a lot more subtle. I want a real driving car that can effortlessly go between a Sunday driver and a canyon carver. I'm going to be putting miles on this thing, so you know it's never really going to see a track day, but I want it to have the ability to perform like a new Mustang. So with that in mind, here are the components that I'm thinking. Number one, engine and transmission. Since I've already got a 67 coupe right over here with the matching numbers 289 and some mild performance upgrades, I want to go a little bit more wild with this fastback build. I'm thinking of dropping in a crate Coyote engine, but not just any crate Coyote engine, the Aluminator 52 XS from Ford Performance. This engine is an absolute beast. It's got 580 horsepower at the crank, all of its performance internals, and it basically is the cross-plane crank version of the Voodoo engine. That's the flat-plane crank that comes in the brand new Shelby GT350s. To complement that engine, I'm thinking of going with the Tremec 6-speed Magnum transmission. My other 67 coupe here has the factory 3-speed C4 automatic, which is a 3-speed auto, and it's just not as fun as a manual. I've always wanted a manual in a Mustang. So there's nothing quite like ripping through the gears on a country road with the tunes cranked up, especially when you've got 6 speeds to go through. Logistically speaking, there's a lot of things that I'll need to consider to make this engine and transmission work in this 67. First thing, obviously, is the shock towers are going to be removed so that you can actually fit the engine in there. The unibody also needs to be strengthened to support the new power plant, and the motor needs to be sitting low enough and mounted low enough that the hood will close, ideally a factory hood, not one with like a Shelby fiberglass scoop or anything like that. It needs to sit low enough so that also the transmission doesn't have to have the tunnel or the firewall modified in order for it to fit in there nicely. Getting the alternator and the column and all the accessories and everything is going to also be a challenge, but going with the Coyote route and specifically with the Aluminator 52XS, car is going to scream. It's going to be high performance, daily drivable car, which is exactly what I'm going for. I plan to put real miles on this thing. Number two, wheels and tires. This one's really important to decide out of the gate because it's going to really dictate what you can do from a suspension and brake standpoint, and a lot of other parts of the build have to start from the wheels and tires. So what I'm trying to do is I want to go with period correct wheels. And so for me, it's going to be the 17-inch VN 427 Shelby-style wheels. But instead of the standard kind of polished ones that you see, I want to go all black with a polished spinner. And I want to wrap those in tires that I can have as wide as possible in the front and as wide as possible in the back without getting, you know, too much pro street style. So ideally, I'd like to get a 255 up front and a 285 in the back. But I think that with those black wheels and having tires with some raised white lettering, it'll have a cool kind of race modern feel to it, but also a nod to the vintage era and period correct wheels that it's from. Obviously the stance, I like it lower than stock. It's sitting really high right now, obviously behind me, because it doesn't have an engine or trans anymore. I pulled that out last weekend. So it's got to be down a little bit lower. Not only is that better for performance, but I just prefer the look of it. Number three, brakes. Brakes are really important. I've got good disc brakes on this coupe all the way around and I love it. I'm gonna go with the biggest brakes that I can fit in those 17-inch wheels, which was gonna be a 13-inch rotor. I'm gonna probably pick between a Wilwood brake, or a bear brake. They both make excellent products. And for me, with a disc brake setup like that, with a six-piston caliper in the front, maybe a four in the rear, maybe a six pot in the rear, not sure, you really don't need any kind of power boosting or hydro boost, in my opinion. Those are fantastic if you want a lot of braking power with minimal effort, but you just don't get the precision that you do with a manual brake that's not powered by any additional boosted brake. And if you've got great calipers and good big rotors like that, I think you're gonna be fine. Suspension, this is a key one. Suspension is the component that I haven't really decided on yet. There's several different outfits who make suspension parts for a classic Mustang like this. And I'm looking for a kit or parts that have good street characteristics but are somewhat race inspired. I wanna have, obviously, coilovers all the way around. I don't need a ton of adjustability like a track car or an autocross car would need. I do want the lowered stance. I've been looking really closely at some products by Cortex Racing. They look fantastic. So do the Detroit Speed setups. But Detroit Speed, it looks like you can only run an 18-inch wheel or bigger on those. So that might be a deal breaker for me, although I really like their products. Customers really seem to enjoy their products a lot. I've also looked at a Roadster Shop chassis. Those look phenomenal. That's kind of a big bolt-on solution. They've got two of them, but one is a bolt-on solution that takes care of all the suspension geometry and all the subframe connectors, because you're essentially bolting a whole new subframe to the subframe unibody. That makes me a little bit nervous because even though I'm not trying to build a track car and reduce the weight in counting every pound that's on there, it just seems like there's a whole lot of extra bulk that would be bolted on and adding 300 or 400 or 500 pounds of more metal. I think I can accomplish something similar by doing some really good subframe connectors and doing some chassis strengthening in the spots where it potentially needs it. Side note on that, I'd love to hear your feedback. What's your experience with vintage Mustang suspension? If you guys are running either a fastback or a coupe, mid-60s, let me know what kind of suspension you're running and what you recommend. I'm open for suggestions because, again, I'm very much undecided on how to set this thing up from a suspension standpoint. Number five, interior. For me, the 1967 Mustang luxury interior, or deluxe interior, is the best looking factory interior of any car from the 60s. So my plan is to do a factory black interior with all the factory brushed accents. And, you know, I want to run the factory floor and roof console, so keep everything looking very much original. For the seats, I think I'm going to do the TMI Sport Seat 2, which has enhanced bolsters in the sides, on the back and on the bottom, and it still looks original, and I would do the original vinyl with the comfort weave inserts, which I think look fantastic. I'm considering adding the Shelby style stealth roll bar just for safety. That's something that tucks kind of nicely and tucks out of the way. People can, or kids can, still get in and out of the back seat if necessary. I don't want it to be too bulky. Again, I'm not trying to build a race car, but I do want to bring the safety standards up to modern. So if that means adding that Shelby style roll bar and then doing the shoulder seat belts, I'd be happy to make that concession. Number six, exterior. Black paint, baby. I love the dark green. In fact, it's really grown on me. Every time I come out here and look at the car sitting outside or in the garage, I really, really like the dark green. But I just can't shake the notion of having a black Mustang. But I'm not talking about building a murdered out Mustang. Those are cool, but I want to keep all the chrome on there that came on there. I love the chrome bumpers. I love the chrome rocker moldings, all the trunk and hood trim, chrome everywhere. I love it. So it's going to be black with all the factory chrome. Again, it's going to look very much like the Raven Black factory colors, just with that slightly lower stance, a little bit modern twist on vintage period correct wheels. That's the look I'm going for from the outside. Before I can get anywhere near the painting stages of this project build, there's going to be a whole lot of work that needs to be done. So black paint requires the body to be laser straight, otherwise it doesn't look good. The whole car is going to need to get stripped down, media blasted, the metal is going to need to be repaired, the floors replaced, definitely. Frame rails up front, yep. These are all going to need some type of addressing and probably metal repair or replacement of panels entirely. So those are things I don't know yet until I really get all the paint and everything media blasted and really assess what the underneath looks like. It could be straightforward. It could be a whole lot of stuff I don't know about yet, so that's an unknown. That's one of the things when you buy a car sight unseen and you don't really get to check that stuff yet. So here's the recap, guys. We're going to build this car to be an absolute driver's car. It's not going to be a show car or a trailer queen. It's going to get driven, and I'm aiming to have this car look just like an original black 67 Mustang Fastback, with the exception of the stance, wheels, and tires. Again, if you look a little bit closely, or obviously if you pop the hood, you'll see that it's got modern underpinnings throughout, but I want those to be very subtle. Again, the first step, and probably for the next couple weeks, there's not going to be a whole lot of stuff because there's disassembly required. Let me know if you have any suggestion or tips, anything that I need to be aware of when I start to dive into this Coyote swap Mustang project. Give me a shout in the comment section below. Let me know what you think. I'd love your insight. If you've done something like this similar, let me know what I'm in for. Thanks again, guys. I appreciate it.